Hi, I'm Will Riddick, and as a physical therapist, one question I get all the time is, should I be using a cane? So, in this walk talk, I'm going to discuss when you should use an assisted device, like this cane, and how you might benefit from using one. Assisted devices are tools that enable people with walking difficulties to walk safely and more efficiently. When used correctly, and when the right one is matched up with the right person, they can make a world of a difference in getting around. However, when used incorrectly or an improper device is chosen, they can actually hinder people's ability to get around. So how do I know if I need anything to help me walk? Oftentimes, this is a conversation with your physician or physical therapist who might see a potential need based on safety or the mechanics or manner in which you walk. They're generally the first to alert you, but I always suggest that if you sense any instability in your walk or any risk for falling during your daily activities, you should consider some sort of assistive device, particularly when you are out in unfamiliar areas, crowded community settings, or on uneven terrain. So, let's say you don't currently use anything to help you walk, but you feel uneasy in your balance. It's likely that your walking impairment is minor. For you, we want to try to add some support only on one side. If you have some kind of pain, injury, or history of injury on one side that continues to impact your walking, we want to place the assistive device on the opposite side of the body. For example, if you have a painful left knee, you would place the device in your right hand. It seems counterintuitive, but placing a device on the same side can actually make it harder for you to walk. Why is that? Well, part of this is because the purpose of the cane is to give you a wider base of support. The base of support refers to the area on the ground that your body has to balance on top of to maintain balance control. This area typically includes your feet and the space immediately between them. Here's mine. When we walk, we only have one foot on the ground for most of the time. So, during this time, our base of support only consists of a single foot. Our body has to then balance over that foot, otherwise we lose our balance and begin to fall. When we have a cane, this gives another point of contact on the ground to increase our base of support. So the point the cane touches on the floor, the space underneath our foot on the ground, and everything in between becomes our new base of support. We gain a lot more stability because our area to balance over is now much wider. If we have the cane on the same side that has an issue, we only increase our base of support by a little bit. But if we place it on the other side, our base of support becomes drastically larger. This gives us stability in difficult situations and improves our balance. So, again, the device goes on the opposite side. There's another reason for this as well, but we'll leave the physics that explain that for another time. If you don't have any one-sided injuries, pain, or impairments that impact your walking, you can actually choose either hand for the assistive device. In this case, most people choose their dominant hand. Let's look at the assistive devices that are utilized in one hand. As I mentioned, if we're dealing with a minor walking impairment, it's likely that we only need support on one side. So, in this category, we have several options available to us, ranging from more to less support. If you feel slightly uncomfortable only when navigating terrain, such as an outdoor walking trail, then a trekking or hiking pole may be sufficient. Single point canes are probably the most popular and are great for people who feel uneasy when traveling outside of the home. If you're looking to buy a single point cane, we recommend that you get one with a single solid point at the end. Points that swivel, move, or have multiple contact points with the ground could result in some unsteadiness. Quad canes and hemi canes are for people who need significant support, as these devices are able to bear a lot of weight, but they can really slow you down when walking. These are really only for a certain population and would only likely be recommended by a physical therapist or a physician. If you don't feel comfortable with only a cane or a trekking pole, we highly recommend you talk to a medical professional in order to get the appropriate device for you. Next, let's look at the assistive devices for individuals who need support on both sides. People in this category have difficulty walking in their home as well as in the community. They might be unable to take a step without support or might need the support to alleviate pain during walking. Oftentimes, people are provided with these devices after a surgery or hospitalization. They're able to offer a lot of support and safety and can help people with extreme difficulty in walking to navigate their environment. So, for assistive devices utilized on both sides, there is again a range of support available. Once again, trekking poles offer the least support, as they are unable to bear full weight. but they maintain a great deal of flexibility. For higher level patients, loft strand crutches and underarm crutches can be very helpful in order to bear considerable weight but enable a good walking technique. Rollators, rolling walkers, and standard walkers offer the most support and can be very helpful for those with significant difficulty in getting around. Rollators are typically for individuals who are still able to navigate their community and are able to manage the brakes and can accommodate for ramps. This is important as rollators can unfortunately roll away from you if care is not taken to avoid this. Rolling walkers and standard walkers are for people who only navigate their home environment or need supervision with walking in the community. For any of these devices, we again highly recommend you talk to a professional, such as a physical therapist, to get the right tool for you. Obviously, there are numerous factors to consider when choosing an assistive device that are beyond the scope of our video. But hopefully this gives you a better understanding of what is available and how an assistive device can be of help. If you find yourself in the category of feeling unstable getting around, you would likely benefit from a rehabilitation program to improve your balance and walking. Working with a physical therapist can help to regain confidence, improve your strength and coordination to make you safer, and it enables a physical therapist to match you up with an appropriate assistive device. So again, if this is you, reach out to your doctor today about participating in physical therapy. Thanks for watching this episode of Walk Talk. We have a lot of fun breaking down different topics for you, and we hope you enjoy our series. In our next episode, we're going to talk about basic strengthening exercises that can help to improve almost anyone's walking. If you're new to Mission Gate, check out our website at missiongate.org. And to see more of these videos, you can either click the link in the corner to subscribe, or you can visit our YouTube channel at youtube.com/missiongate.